Can you tell me what that is?
I mean, if you watch Cody's video, you can see how he proved it's a diamond. I don't know if I trust those ways, but... Oh yeah, that's diamond.
Try putting it, like, actually on your tongue.
That sounds a little too science-y for me.
Should feel cold.
Is it cold?
Yep, it's cold. Apparently by science.
Does that mean it's a diamond?
Well, there's a reason why diamonds have a nickname of ice. Because they pull the heat out so fast, if you put a big enough one on your tongue, it feels like a piece of ice.
I thought it was because they were clear like ice cubes.
No. Okay, that one's obviously not clear. So, that is a very large diamond. 17 carats, I think it was.
And as you guys have probably noticed by now, Cody is a lot smarter than we are.
And it didn't even taste like carrots.
So we have a 17-carat diamond, and this is just a raw diamond.
It's not really gem quality. It's got lots of inclusions and stuff, but it's still hard, heavy.
So even though it doesn't look like your standard, typical diamond, this is, in fact, a diamond.
And Cody actually proved this in your video.
Right.
And now you want to see if we can cut it.
Yeah, I'm really curious, you know, that you got garnet, right?
Yeah.
The garnet, I think, was an 8. Diamond's 10. Just the high-speed 8 particles.
We don't care 10. Who's prettier, okay?
Let's strap it down and see what we can do to it.
Hit it with the high-pressure jet right along there.
Yeah, we'll follow that edge of the strap right there, see if we can cut that front end off. Here we've got the thickness about 1/4 inch, and the material is PCD, which... we are told stands for politically correct diamond, is that it?
Yeah, that's what Cody said. Marked as the hardest option on here.
Significantly harder than tungsten, which is at 0.9 right there.
And molybdenum.
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 One half of a diamond. And that took a fraction of the time I was expecting.
It's crazy still to see it kind of directing the beam of water out.
Yeah, it must have hit something harder.
It probably
in the
just
middle.
Like got an angle going.
Or thicker.
Couldn't it definitely just ground right through it though, didn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, maybe it was just a thicker section of it, but yeah, Waterjet. If you just throw enough garnet at a diamond for long enough, it'll cut through it. Okay, so this begs the question then. What is harder than a diamond that we can challenge ourselves with now?
Something synthetic. Boron nitride, maybe?
Boron nitride.
I don't even know where I'd get a piece of that.
Mitchell knows a guy at eBay, so...
we'll find a way.
We're good.
He's never heard of eBay before.
This guy. Well, I think you guys should definitely keep a piece of this for your wall of shame, is what you're calling it?
Wall of shame? That's what we should call it.
Everything that's been shamed by a water jet belongs here.
For those of you that don't know, this has been Cody that's been helping us. He has a YouTube channel called Cody's Lab. He does a lot of geological tests and experiments and... plays with cool chemicals and flushes mercury down toilets and one time. He does a lot of cool stuff. On his channel, he did a video about this diamond that we cut, and he does a bunch of tests to prove that it is a real diamond. So go ahead, go over there, check out his channel. Maybe you'll learn something, which you obviously never do on our channel.
What's that supposed to mean?